Right, welcome along guys to an indie game review. Gonna start off with Lumberjack. The game's a lot like Streets of Rage, you just walk backwards and forwards. You would lumberjack with an axe, as the name suggests, and you push A and X to do quick attacks and B and Y to do heavy attacks. Wasn't a bad game, like, it's quite gory, quite good fun. The only downside is you can't like jump run or anything, so it's very like just walk forwards and hit everything based, but it wasn't a bad game. I thought it looked pretty good for like an indie game, and it wasn't too like was quite a lot of fun, so it wasn't too bad. So yeah, give it a download if it looks like something you'd like, and I'll go on to the next game, which is called WoOOPuP. This game I thought was awesome. It reminds me of a game I used to have on a Sega handheld when I was younger. I can't remember the name of it, but I used to have it. Basically, you've got the little platform, you just bounce the ball around the screen. There's different power-ups. If you hit the star in the middle, you get a bonus level, where you have to collect all the stars in the time limit. You've got like 20 seconds, I'm guessing, because it counts down in the background. Which I thought was quite cool. It's all points-based. Quite a good laugh, and you get power-ups for like the little platform as well. That mean you can shoot stuff on that. And yeah, I actually really enjoyed this. I think it was like really good-looking for an indie game. Could have been an arcade game, and you wouldn't know the difference. And the controls are really smooth. You just use the joystick to move around and A to use your power-up, so you can't really fault it. So yeah, right, let's see what's next. This one's called Without Escape. Now, I haven't bothered playing this because it's a game like where you just click on stuff and it tells you, like an investigation sort of style game. So I thought if it's your kind of game, then give it a go. If not, then don't worry. And I'll go straight on to the next game, which is War in a Box, which is this. Either I really suck at this game or it wasn't that great. I wasn't really sure what was going on. You move around with one joystick and you look around with the other one and you pushed A to shoot. And that was about as far as I got. So maybe give it a shot, but I didn't think it was that great. This game, however, Red Invasion Tower Defense, I thought was awesome. It's a tower defense game where you just build towers, upgrade them. You have like weird little towers. It's in the bottom left of the screen right now, where you like harvest energy from kills and stuff. And you build up the towers and they blow stuff up and you defend your base, and that was pretty much it. And the final game this week is called 48 Chambers, which I thought was pretty good. It's basically a bit of a puzzler. You just have to navigate through the maps. You can boost a little red dot. You have to avoid the obstacles and the challenges and stuff. And yeah, I actually really like that game as well, so maybe give that a shot. Cheers for watching, guys, and take it easy.